Hey everyone, this is Pastor Anthony Nix from Anderson Seventh-day Adventist Church with another weekly devotional entitled, A Chance to Choose. The scripture for today is, But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. Genesis chapter 2, verse 17. Though Adam and Eve were created innocent and holy, they were not beyond the ability of wrongdoing. At the very beginning of human existence, a check was placed upon the desire for self-indulgence. The tree of the knowledge of good and evil was right next to the tree of life, and the order was given by God that the tree of the knowledge of good and evil was not permissible to eat from. They were to be tested of their loyalty and exposed to the temptations of Satan, and if they were to pass this test, then they were forever to be out of the grasp of Satan's power, and they can enjoy the communion that they would have with God. God very well could have created Adam and Eve without the capacity to sin. He could have stopped Eve before she took hold of the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. But if this were the case, then Adam and Eve would not have free will, and they would not be able to develop characters according to God. It would have been unworthy of intelligent humans that God would do something like this, and it would have sustained Satan's attack on God's character as being an imposing arbiter. God made man with moral uprightness and a will to develop character and no bias towards evil. God gave humans strong intellectual powers and presented before them the strongest possible inducements for them to say yes to God. Perfect and perpetual obedience is the condition for eternal happiness. I'm going to repeat that. Perfect and perpetual obedience is the condition for eternal happiness, and it enables us to eat of the tree of life again. God longs as they remained loyal to the divine law. He wanted them to remain loyal to God's law and have the capacity to know and enjoy and to love, and that capacity would increase throughout the ages. They would be constantly gaining new treasures of knowledge, discovering fresh springs of happiness, and obtaining clearer and yet clearer conceptions of the immeasurable, unfailing love of God. God is giving every human being today the same ability to choose Him instead of sin. He is calling us to choose Him, to be with Him, to walk with Him, to be loyal to Him. He's never going to force you. He's never going to force me. He's never going to exert His power of force upon you. But He calls you with strings of love, with His arms outstretched, to follow Him, to be in relationship with Him, and to love Him more than we love our desire to fulfill our passions. Now, what are you going to choose today? Are you going to choose? Choose Jesus.